get started, I've called this regular Finance Committee meeting to order. The first bill is Senate Print 134, Senator Little.
This is an act to amend the real property tax law in relation to expanding the enhanced STAR exemption to the disabled surviving spouse of a previously qualifying individual.
Comments?
Move it.
Moved by Senator Larkin, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? The bill is reported out. 935.
This is an act to amend the vehicle and traffic law in relation to establishing the Schools Safety Zone Act by Senator Marcelino.
Comments?
Move it.
Moved by Senator Larkin, seconded by Senator Krueger. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? The bill is reported out. 1408.
By Senator Hannan, it's an act to amend the public health law in relation to administering the hepatitis B immunization to minors housed in state or local correctional facilities.
Move it.
Second.
Moved by Larkin, seconded by Krueger. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? The bill is reported out. Time out. All right, 1505
by Senator Griffo. It's an act to amend the tax law in relation to the volunteer firefighters and ambulance workers credit.
Questions?
Yes.
Senator Krueger.
So this allows them to have both a personal income tax credit in their state taxes and a property tax credit. My understanding is up till now it's been an either or, and that the governor had previously vetoed. Is there anything different in this bill than the last time it was vetoed?
Yes, we have a different governor. And hope springs eternal.
Do we have a projection of how much this would cost the state of New York?
The property tax exemption would only deal with property taxes for the localities, and the income tax exemption $200. How much?
It's $200 per person.
$200 per person that would be eligible. I don't know how many veterans there are.
It's not veterans, it's people.
I mean,
firefighters or ambulance.
Right.
My concern in supporting this bill would be that we don't know the full impact on the state. There's currently 70,000 who file for the state personal income tax. It costs us, I think, $14 million in this tax year. And so the concern is that it could be a significant increase in the dollar cost. Also, because of the way taxes are done, we actually don't know how many people are filing for one versus the other, if not both now, because I don't believe state taxes cross-references on property tax and vice versa. So I'm going to vote no, because I don't think we know enough about the answers and the impact on the state budget.
Okay.
Thank you.
Is there a motion?
Move it.
Moved by Senator Marcelino, second by Senator Larkin. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Negative by Senator Krueger. Senator Rivera, without rec for Senator Rivera. The bill is reported out. 1538.
By Senator Skelos, it's an act to amend the Family Court Act and the Domestic Relations Law in relation to abandoned infants.
Questions? Yes, Senator Krueger.
As I read this bill, the history of the bill predates a law we passed last year that became law, which already changed the formula for allowing the release of abandoned infants 30 days after abandonment. As I read this bill, it would actually, just a year later, jump that down to 5 or 6 business days. Proceedings commence within 6 business days. Clearly, you do not want infants languishing in foster care if they, in fact, could be adopted. But there are any number of reasons that a new mother might find herself abandoning her infant, and then after a cooling off period, realizing this is not what she wanted. Nor actually in the best interest of the infant. There are cases of postpartum depression, where the mother is not aware of why she is in panic and hysteria and doesn't feel that she can care for the child, but you can imagine easily her finding medical assistance within 2 or 3 weeks that can assist her to get the help she needs. Very often in postpartum depression, it's actually a chemical and hormonal imbalance that is easily treated by drugs, and I would hate to imagine that the state of New York rushed forward too quickly to release a child for adoption when in fact the mother could get access to needed health care and reverse her position and her understanding of the situation she was in. I just think this bill cuts the timeline for movement from foster care into adoption to way too quick a timeline. And I would not recommend that the state go down this road. I'll be voting no.
Well, the investigation requires that the proceeding to determine whether a child is abandoned has to be commenced within 6 days of the initial allegation. But the child isn't freed up for adoption until 60 days after the determination. So it's not a matter of less than a week that a child will be
freed
for adoption.
You're correct. The child would not be freed for adoption. I just believe that really 1 week is too short a period to start the system going into place. If an infant is in a safe custodial care situation for several weeks before the government starts any kind of proceeding, I don't think it's going to actually delay the best interest of the child if they can't be reunited with the parent or parents. I just think 6 days is too short a time frame to be making these decisions.
Again, the decision is not made in 6 days. This process starts so that within 60 days, a petition, a finding can be made of abandonment. So the parents actually have 60 days. And I would think that whatever the circumstances might be, after 60 days, you probably should make up your mind. Especially when a child is just languishing somewhere until the process is determined. So I can understand the difference of opinion, but I think that 60 days the parents have to come forward. That's at least 60 days. All right, it's moved by Senator Larkin. Seconded by Senator Golden. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? No from Senator Kruger. The bill is reported out. 2352.
By Senator Grassanti, it's an act to amend the education law in relation to the instruction on history of people with disabilities.
Questions? Comments? Moved by Senator. Question?
No,
moved by Senator Larkin, seconded by Senator Kruger. All in favor?
Aye.
The bill is reported out. 2678, Senator Larkin.
This is an act to amend the tax law in relation to providing an exemption from sales and compensating use taxes for certain aircraft purchased in the state.
Questions? Comments? Question. I'm sorry.
That's okay. Thank you. I know we're moving along quickly. I know that I followed up with Senator Larkin's office, and I appreciate his intent with this bill, but I do not think it's in the best interest of the state to give up sales tax on sales of such expensive and statistically luxury items. There is an argument that is being made that we will make more money by selling more airplanes if we don't have the sales tax. And there is a 2009 report on the impact of other related aircraft maintenance taxes, but I, despite that, I don't believe it's in the best interest of the state to end sales tax for luxury items, so I'll be voting no.
Moved by Senator Larkin, seconded by Senator Marcellino. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Senators Rivera. What's your name?
Senator
Stewart. Senator Kruger.
Without rec.
And without rec, Senator Stewart, because I had a blank.
Grassanti.
The bill is reported out. Okay, next bill, 3191, Senator Ranzenhofer.
This is an act to amend the tax law in relation to the Small Business Electric Energy Tax Credit.
Senator Krueger.
What is the fiscal analysis of the cost of this bill to the state?
Let me find it here.
$350 million.
Thank you. That is actually very similar to the back of the envelope analysis I did. And since it's only for companies with 19 full-time employees or less, you wouldn't be encouraging small businesses to grow because they'd hate to lose this tax credit that they were getting. It's not specific to manufacturing or other energy-using companies. It seems like it would disproportionately impact smaller, white-collar types of businesses, although the state shows 360,000 businesses who could be eligible for this. Where would we get the replacement $350 million in our budget?
Well, by increased economic activity by the engine of small business.
How would they increase their economic activity? Because they wouldn't want to go one person over 19 because then they'd drop to zero their tax credit. So what would motivate them to grow?
Well, I would guess that not every small business is 19 employees, and there are many that have 3, 5, 10, and you can increase their employment up to that level. And if this is successful, maybe we can expand it to businesses with less than 50 employees. But it's at least a start to see to try to help small businesses, which unfortunately are not helped very much in the scheme of things with state programs.
And has there been any analysis done about what kinds of businesses fall into the 360,000 business categories so we would better understand whether a drop in their electric costs are in fact is the motivating factor in whether or not they can grow their businesses? It works out to an average of about $900 per year per business, and research shows that very broad and relatively small tax credits and incentives don't actually change the business practices or business expansion of companies. So where's our evidence that a $900 on average across the board to 360,000 businesses of 19 and below would actually be a motivator of increased economic activity?
Well, they're small businesses that this is really targeted after is the ones that would get the most savings and have the most benefit would be small manufacturers. And there are many small manufacturers in the state of New York that employ a small number of people but use high energy. And that's where we think the growth would become. I'm sure it's not going to incentivize necessarily a bookkeeping company to have another employee if their energy costs are relatively low. I think the main benefit is going to be the small manufacturers.
Then why not, as we have other energy and tax incentives for manufacturers, why not make this a law specific to those kinds of companies since this is not a targeted program at all?
That's an excellent idea, but this bill by this sponsor made it broad, and certainly we could talk to him about potential amendments, and or another bill could be put in next year.
I will be opposed to the bill. It's a cost of $350 million. It is a broad and non-targeted tax credit where there's not research evidence that it will actually change the economic behavior of any specific company or types of companies. And again, because of the very small full-time equivalent population of workers, 19 or less, actually can discourage certain kinds of companies from growing beyond 19 workers. In my opinion, this is the kind of tax credit and or exemption program that the state should be weaning itself off of, as opposed to well-researched and targeted programs of investment in those companies that actually show that they can and will grow in exchange for a reduction in their taxes. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Is there a motion?
Moved.
Moved by Senator Larkin, seconded by Senator Golden. All in favor? I assume those are ayes someplace. And opposed?
Opposed.
Senators Rivera and Krueger and Peralta?
Okay.
No, you said, where's Peralta? He's not even here. It's Rivera. It's Rivera.
We're giving you...
We don't have a press. Sorry, Senator, I was looking...
It's contagious. I had the laps. Now he had the laps. So.
This is Stuart Cousins.
And this is just the beginning of this week.
That's right.
3410.
This is by Senator Golden. It's an act to amend the tax law in relation to the tax on certain tobacco products.
Questions? Okay. No questions. Move the bill by Senator Marcelino.
Just a quick statement. This would be, again, a lower tax rate for luxury tobacco items as opposed to other tobacco items that I neither see a justification for from the perspective of equity and tax policy, or a justification in terms of, I think we want to continue discouraging people from using tobacco products because, they kill them. So I'll be voting no.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes.
Senator Actually, Bowie. That tax costs the state of New York money. Actually, the people stopped buying the cigars in the state of New York and started buying them through the internet, and we actually lost tax revenues because of that. Increase in taxes to cigars. This would justify bringing that price down so that it could be a competitive business here in the city of the state of New York and increase tax revenues.
Senator Rivera.
I will also be opposing this bill. It seems that creating tax exemption for basic cancer seems to me not to be a very smart policy in the long term. I don't question Senator Golden's what he's trying to protect here. I'm not sure how much revenue it costs, how much revenue it would generate. Unlikely that it's going to generate millions of dollars. So I will be voting in the negative on this one.
Okay. As a motion by Senator Golden, seconded by Senator Larkin. All in favor? Aye. There's opposed. Our Senators Rivera, Gianaris, and Krueger.
Thank you.
The bill is moved.
And Senator Golden.
And Stuart Cousin. 3420, Senator Flanagan.
This is an act to authorize the Holy Cross Polish National Church to retroactively apply for real property tax exemption.
Motion by Senator Larkin, seconded by Senator Marcelino. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
Without rec.
Without rec, Senator Stuart Cousins. And Senator Rivera. 3556, LaBelle.
This is an act to amend the education law in relation to the licensure of dietitians and nutritionists.
Moved by Senator Marcelino, seconded by Senator Rivera. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? The bill is moved. 3994A, Golden.
This is an act to amend the general municipal law and the retirement and social security law in relation to increasing special accidental death benefits.
Motion by Senator Golden, seconded by Senator Larkin. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? The bill is reported out. 4005A, DeSillo.
This is an act to amend the insurance law in relation to coverage for the screening, diagnosis, and treatment of autism.
Second.
Moved by Senator Rivera, seconded by Senator Krueger. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? The bill is reported out. Next bill, 4200, Senator Hannon.
This is an act to amend the State Medical Care Facilities Finance Agency Act in relation to the ability to issue certain bonds and notes.
Moved by Senator Marcelino, seconded by Senator Larkin. All in favor?
Aye.
The bill is reported out. Next bill is Senate 4655, Skelos.
This is an act to amend the Volunteer Firefighters Benefit Law in relation to the New York State Fallen Firefighter Memorial.
Moved by Senator Marcelino, seconded by Senator Golden. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? The bill is reported out. 4662, Bonasek.
This is an act to amend the general municipal law in relation to poker tournaments.
this goes hand in hand with the cigar bill. See.
Question.
Question by Senator Krueger.
Could you just, there's two of these similar bills on this today. Explain what a charitable, bona fide charitable organization is under these kinds of laws. So it says it would allow this kind of gambling and games of chance for bona fide charitable organizations for fundraising purposes. Is that a very broad definition or a limited definition somewhere?
Go ahead.
Senator, there are specific organizations that are defined as 501c3 charitable organizations pursuant to both the federal tax code and the not-for-profit corporation law and our state's religious corporation law. Mm-hmm. They're in effect charities and churches.
So it's anything that's recognized as 501c3 under federal and state charitable.
And they also have to register with the Department of Law here, with the Attorney General's office.
And then they can participate in these charitable poker and bell jar activities whenever they like?
What happens is this is classified as those games of chance, and pursuant to the general municipal law, there are a list of games of chance that they can do. They can do, you know, roulette wheel and several other things that they can allow them to do for fundraising purposes.
And my understanding is this bill and the
just
this
one more
game. Poker and bell jar to the list. And does anyone go adding up all this money and how much gambling is actually taking place
Absolutely.
Through these
all
programs?
All these games of chance can be registered with the local registrar or the village and town clerk and municipality in which they take place. They're added up and the totals are overall handed.
So it's the
state gets its share. The organization gets its share. All the books are updated and audited in the controller's office, audits the mayor. I know this because I did it for 8 years.
And local governments, when I was in it, they wanted this for years and years.
And the local government has to individually approve or not approve this, or they don't have any role to not approve it?
They can approve the site. You can approve the site, you set the qualifications of the entity that's filed for the application, you check their status, the 501c status, you check the site for the safety, and you're looking for fire safety, there's a code.
Thank you.
Any other questions? Moved by Senator Larkin, seconded by Senator Marcellino. All in favor?
I'm an outlaw.
After that excellent.
Just so you know about it.
Senator Marcellino, without record. The bill is reported out, 4763, Farley.
This is an act to amend the executive law in relation to including the Sacandaga River within the definition of inland waterways for the purposes of revitalization grants.
Move it.
Moved by Senator Larkin, seconded by Senator Rivera. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? The bill is reported, 4898, Golden.
This is an act to amend the tax law and other laws related to the Metropolitan Transportation Authority in relation to extending certain provisions thereof with respect to the resolution of labor disputes.
Moved by Senator Larkin, seconded by Senator Marcellino. All in favor?
Aye.
Without much, anybody else? Yes, okay, so the bill is reported out. 5140B, Farley.
This is an act to amend the tax law in relation to establishing the Taxpayer Refund Choice Act.
Moved by Senator Larkin, seconded by Senator Rivera. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? The bill is reported out. 5223A, Libous.
This is actually a B print, sir.
It's actually a B print.
Right.
Okay.
This is an act to amend the economic development law in relation to the establishment of Centers of Excellence program.
What if the B print change?
The term majority leader to temporary president.
Now, as I read this bill, Centers for Excellence haven't received new funding in the state budget for an extended number of years.
What is the Center of Excellence?
I'm sorry.
What is the Center of Excellence?
Well, I think it was during the Pataki administration, there were, I think, five centers of excellence at different areas of the state. I know Syracuse has one, and I think Rochester does. Other cities have.
Are they educational institutions?
In Syracuse, it's the emphasis is air quality, and it's in conjunction with the universities in the area to try to attract businesses in this center of excellence and generate new businesses with the research from the institutions and businesses partnering with them. I think, isn't Nanotech here in Albany that has been the most successful example of that? So that's what the Centers of Excellence are.
It could be an educational institution, but it doesn't have to be an education.
Correct, but they're all really tied into educational institutions, affiliates. They're affiliates. They're not really run by the educational institution, but that's one of the partners along with the businesses in the area.
And it was funded in our Pataki.
Yeah, during the Pataki years. Yeah, and they're also, just reminding me, they are still funded in the executive budget every year, including this year.
And why would we need to put this program into statute at this point after it's been in existence since 2002?
2002. Why don't you explain it?
Okay. Go ahead. Under Chapter 84, Section of 2002, when they were created, it was, the section that creates them essentially for their creation, not the continuation of funding. Since we have been continuously funding them since 2002, this bill would just simply codify it in law to ensure their ongoing operations. And it also increases reporting by the Centers of Excellence.
May I continue to ask Mary a question?
Sure.
Thank you. And Mary, who would do the reporting on this? Under our existing structure for economic development, NYSTAR got rolled into ESDC, and this would be a responsibility of ESDC?
It's actually a responsibility of the Centers of Excellence to report, they're now formulated, since NYSTAR got merged into the Department of Economic Development, so they would be reporting to the Department of Economic Development, and then the Department of Economic Development will also create a report with regards to their operations and what they're commercializing and the products that they're commercializing.
So each center would have a responsibility for creating an annual report to the legislature, or DOD would have a responsibility for providing a report to the legislature.
Yes.
Which?
I believe it's both, but let me just double check.
It's both.
And then there's a one-to-one match basis for institutions being codified into this. Could you explain that for me?
It's like just codifying what their existing match is. That's nothing new.
Okay. And it doesn't require, there's nothing in this bill that requires a further commitment of money in future years from the states.
No. It's just we appropriate money every year. The appropriation lapses every year. Mm-hmm. There are reappropriations that we have, but it's just strictly with regards to funding under the executive budget. There's no continuous money at this point.
Thank you.
Moved by Senator Larkin, seconded by Senator Marcelino. All in favor? Opposed? The bill without rec, Senator Rivera. The bill is reported out. 5326, Larkin.
This is an act to amend the general municipal law in relation to authorizing the conducting of event games, which is Bell Jar, by organizations authorized to conduct games of chance.
Moved by Senator Larkin, seconded by Senator Marcelino. All in favor? Opposed? The bill is reported out. 5445 to Shillow.
This is an act to amend the transportation law, the executive law, and the public authorities law in relation to authorizing innovative infrastructure development.
Senator Krueger.
Thank you. So these models can allow for the privatization of roads and bridges and other currently held public structures. Is that correct?
That is correct.
It is done in many other states. It's been very controversial in many other states. What kind of public participation will there be in any deal that would go forward under this law?
Well, I'd have to read it more carefully, but I assume there's got to be public hearings. I would guess if we're,
yes,
we're transferring public property in a public-private partnership, there'd have to be public hearings. I'm sure it's in here someplace in this 25-page bill. I haven't read it recently, but...
And in this bill, could literally the state transfer ownership of our roads and bridges to a private company?
They could.
Could we transfer ownership to a foreign company?
I don't know. Senator Larkin.
Let's talk about that. When we had the hearing concerning the three P's, the Commissioner of Transportation solidly backed this, stated, as did MTA and the Thruway Authority, that there was no way in Hayes could they ever assess the dollars that is needed to bring the infrastructure up to what it should be. This was the vehicle that should be pursued. There's a lot of work. I understand where your questions are coming from, Liz, but I think there's a lot of work that Senator Fusillo and his team have done. And when all the people that were testifying that day, everyone had a positive thing to say about this. You know, there are states like Indiana. Daniels in Indiana did a great job on what they were doing. Chicago has done it. Texas has done it. Utah has done it. I'm not saying that there aren't pitfalls, but I do think it's something that we ought to move forward on, even if we just get it in there and let these agencies, the agencies are going to be the movers and the shakers, the way I read it. And I've talked to these many of them. One of the biggest ones, and I think we had something before Cambridge when we were talking about the Tappan Zee Bridge. There's no way we could ever tackle the Tappan Zees. And we had, over the last 6-8 years, people who wanted to talk about the partnership, but nobody could get into the partnership itself. Because there was no law to guide it. I think that the purpose of this, I'm just saying my personal, I'm not talking for Fusillo or anybody else, but having sat there for 3 hours listening to testimony, it was quite clear that these agencies were saying, if you want us to fix your potholes and your roads and your bridges, this is the vehicle to do it with.
I agree with you, it's an extraordinarily complex situation to deal with our crumbling infrastructure, and that we have any number of projects in the state with enormous price tags attached. Certainly the Tappan Zee Bridge is the most obvious example, which I think at last count had a something like $12 billion or more price tag, $15 billion. So you pick a year, you see another billion or two get grow on. And yes, private public partnerships mean a lot of different things and can be done in a lot of different ways. My concern is, in fact, based on the same states that you used as examples. Indiana privatized a roadway where the tolls have skyrocketed beyond anything that they imagine. And the people of Indiana are now stuck with this incredibly high toll cost. Chicago privatized their parking meters, and the new mayor is now evaluating whether he can get out of this 25-35-year contract for the privatized parking meters because the unintended consequences of that decision. Texas went into a deal that took six, 7 years to decide about whether to privatize or not privatize a roadway. And in the final analysis, they concluded it was better if they did it themselves, and they didn't go forward with the private contract. Other places, New Jersey made the decision not to go down that road, having explored it. Truly, these are very technical details, and the devil's in the details. Some places have found they went into arrangements. The company then defaulted on what they could do, saying it was too expensive, and the state ended up having to pick up all these additional costs because they could not have a fundamental piece of infrastructure, even if the company, the private company, defaulted. So I agree it's very complicated. I personally think that this legislature, both houses, ought to be looking very, very carefully at the details within the legislation, what it would allow for, what it wouldn't, what would the decision-making process be over the specific projects, because the good news is there's a lot of lessons out there at this point from around the country of unintended consequences, the cost factors, and what are the right ways and wrong ways to do it. So my hesitancy, and the reason I'll vote no today, is I think that we should be spending more time as a legislative body really focusing on the specific issues allowed or not allowed within this bill. I'm glad to know that Senator Fischilla did a 3-hour hearing. I don't know if everybody there testified in favor. I have some memos of opposition, so whether the people who are opposing today were at the hearing or not, I don't know. But I think there's a huge number of questions going forward for the state of New York, and particularly given the lessons from some of our other neighboring and faraway states about what went wrong when they tried to do this. I think we should be very careful legislating the right to privatize the state's infrastructure without an enormous amount of oversight before we pass legislation, and to ensure actual oversight of every possible project that would go forward. So I'll be voting no. Thank you, Senator.
Senator Marcellino is moving the bill, or he wants to speak?
No, I'd like to say this bill, as I read it, doesn't mandate any specific public-private partnership. It simply says that the state is allowed to.
Through an authority.
I attended that hearing. It was kind of very thorough, very good. Liz, I suggest what you were talking about is certainly worthwhile. And I would suggest that, because I'm not one who likes to public assets, the people's assets, in any way, shape, or form. So this allows for the process to move forward, more appropriate to go forward, where not appropriate not to. So I don't think we're worse off by this bill. I think we're, in fact, opening a door which will lead us in a positive direction for this state. I'm going to vote on it.
Senator Rivera.
I will be voting no on this bill. I share a lot of concerns that Senator Kluger brought up. I find myself strongly in opposition to the notion that public works should be privatized. The idea behind having public works is when you have it is not a profit, it's a venture. It is something that is necessary for the majority of the people in a particular region, whether it's a bridge or a road or anything of that nature that is going to be used by the majority of the population. It will likely not be a profit-making venture. To inject a private entity, and which is by default profit-driven, I find it very problematic that we take something that should be used or should be accessible to everyone and make it inject the private sector in there when if it's a profit-driven entity that gets involved, they're going to look for a way to make money. And bridges and roads sometimes don't make money. So what does that mean ultimately for the public? And I think that the example that Senator Kruger gave about this road, which now is in private hands, and they can charge all sorts of tolls because they need to make money, I think it's really problematic. I do not discount the difficulties involved in trying to put together very complex and large public works projects and just very big capital projects. but the notion of injecting a private entity in a way, a profit-making entity, into a process that should be, I believe, the main public process is problematic to me. Very much so. So I would be going in the negative on this, but very strong.
Senator Larkin.
One final thing, following up on what Carl said, that those who were present at the meeting, those who weren't, read the bill. The bill doesn't give you carte blanche to do certain things. What this bill says is here are some parameters that you can watch out for. The message that I got from the MTA, the Thruway Authority, and the DOT was this gives them a vehicle to go out and look at something. They will provide the rules and regs. The Texas thing that you're talking about, I talked to many of them because I meet on other issues. They said the problem was they didn't have any guidelines for the agencies to look at. This here will provide, as the participants at the hearing said, I agree with you, Liz, that we just can't go out there and do it. But we in the state of New York are trying to do a model, and we're trying to set forth. I think the Solomon's group did a great job. I think the hearing was excellent. There were a lot of givers and takers, but the commissioner of DOT made it very emphatic. I cannot do anything because I do not have any money. And if she's going to be able to partnership, she said people are going to be responsible. Now, if you look at her background, you'll find out that she's a hard bargainer, that she's a good choice for the job she has. I think that we ought to pass this bill out. I think that when it's passed, I would certainly believe that the governor would ensure that the main participants to work on this project will be able to come up with rules and regulations that we can all be proud of at a later date. Move the bill.
Moved by Senator Larkin. Second by Senator Marcelino. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Senators Vera and Krueger.
Without rec.
And without rec, Senator Stuart Cousins. The bill is reported out. The next bill, Roebuck bill, is withdrawn by the sponsor. 5665.
By Senator DeFrancisco, it's an act to amend Chapter 57 of the laws of 2008, providing for the administration of certain funds and accounts in relation to the extension of certain provisions thereof.
Questions? Moved by Senator Larkin, seconded by Senator Rivera. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? The bill is reported out. That ends the meeting, and the meeting is adjourned.